So, hello. Today I want to present you our new product, Arwin Simulation. It's a new standalone program solving for you a streamline issue in a numerical wind tunnel. To explain you what you can do directly with the program, you can see here two pictures. One is of a typical wind standard and the right one is typical not ruled shape where you don't get value from a code. On the left side picture you see a two pitch truth where the stream lines running around this shape and you get on the left side a pressure region and on the right side a suction region, and you can see here these turbulences around. And these effects from the streamlines around these two pitched roofs are ruled by typical wind standards, and you get at least some CP values to envelope resulting wind loads on the structural shape for further calculation. In the picture, on the right picture, you see a wedged shape building. At least it's similar. You have a pressure side, suction side. But this wedge shape leads to the situation that you have no real values, or you don't get real values from standard, and you have to interpret the standard to solve it somehow. And we want to solve or to help with our new program to envelope here resulting wind loads on also on such complex shape buildings. For this, I planned to do a live demo to model this wedge shape building in RFAM and to move it in the numerical wind tunnel for a CFD calculation and to transport back the resulting wind loads on surfaces of the building and to do further structural calculation. For this, I change to RFAM and model here at first this wedge shape building. Here we use lines at first. First line have a length of 108 meter. I define it here with this length and direction command here with angle 0 degree. Then we can place here the first line. It's the long side of the building, and then we define here a further line with the length of 85 meter with minus 90 degree, and this we place here on the right side, and the third with 22 meters and we place it here on the origin. Now we combine these two free nodes and get the floor plan of the building. The grid we can hide, and now we use this geometric and produce the walls of the buildings. Here you can see I move copy one element and the building height is here 105 meter, and I define here please create a new surface between the origin line and the copied one. So then we had the four walls around, and now we have to create the roof. For the roof, I plan some special shaped roof. For this, I display only the upper lines here, divide these two long lines by two nodes, two pieces. Okay, this back wall we divide by one element. So, and now we define here some intermediate node between these two nodes, and now we have at least these main geometric points defining the roof. I define it, or I create here now lines in between. It looks a little bit strange in begin, but when I'm finished, I think you will see it's a quite famous building. So here we have also to combine now. In the next step, we create on this few lines an intermediate node, but without dividing the line itself. This means I did write here one and check this option place new nodes on line without dividing it. This gives us this intermediate nodes here in the middle of the line. These nodes I try to select here. I think it's starting from node 15 to 31. These nodes I select here and move it down with minus 6 meter, for example. So now it looks quite cornered, but we select these lines here in the table. Select here, then we say please show us only selected elements, and we change the line type to arcs. And now we mark the full or select the full column and use the command set and change all lines to arcs. Now we have this special roof shape, at least the boundary lines, and we fill these boundary lines with surfaces. Here I use command quadrangle surface and pick one by one lines to get these biaxial curved surfaces. So pick, and now we can close the roof with these gray surfaces. So next step, you see, this is the basic geometric of this building I want to show you. It's really simplified or modeled. For me, it's now important to show you you can use all type of elements of Orpheum. It's possible to use members, shells, solids. Of course, this building could contain some slabs and walls, but at the moment we are interested only in the outer surfaces. Therefore, I model only this one, and that we can do a calculation afterwards. I assign to this element, let's say, a thickness of 500 millimeters. So, and of course a material. So, now it's gray completely, and that we can run afterwards a calculation. I assign a support at the bottom here. So in next step we can start thinking about generating wind loads with our wind simulation. But for this you have to know that you can transport the graphics, what we see here, to our wind simulation, and these graphics are, let's say, influenced from the meshing, and that we get, let's say, a model which is not too detailed. I assign here a quite rough mesh because it's, well, let's say not rough, it's relative to model size because it's quite high and have a big length here. So we assign here not zero, a half a meters and 5 meters. So if we mesh it, let's check if it's possible generate mesh. Yes, you see, so everything fine, and we can start generating wind loads on it. For this I save it and open in the menu calculate this function rwind simulation. Here you get the interface to our wind simulation, the interface which transports our model, what we see in background, into this numerical wind tunnel. And this interface have three tabs here. You see one which is describing the wind load, one which is describing the final load cases, and one which describing some settings about. In the first tab you can define the wind directions if you have only wind applied, for example, in 0 degree directions. This means in X, or if you want to apply a wind all 90 degree segments, this means now in X, Y, minus x, minus y, and so on. I think this is enough for this building here, or only for showing you. If I change the top, you will see the program generates automatically load cases for these increments. In the next step, you have to define the wind speed diagram itself, which should be used in this wind tunnel. To do this, we have programmed here wind speed diagram generator according standard, according European standard. Here in the first instance, you can select, for example, the German annex. You can define here the wind zone. If you don't know the wind zone, you can use our load maps from our GeoZone tool on our website. For this, I have here opened a Chrome tab where you see on our website below solutions this load map site where you can, for example, go to wind load on German annex. And when you know which building we want to design, for example, here this Elbphilharmonie in Hamburg, you see this database behind knows this place. We gather information, it's wind zone 2-star. This 2-star means that this building or site is inside the port of Hamburg. And when we scroll in or zoom in, you will see this in on the satellite photo. This building, what we just modeled, is placed here, and we want to simulate a wind flow from the right to left side with effect of these buildings finally. This 2-star wind zone means we have to fulfill all demands of Port of Hamburg, and this means it should be analyzed with Terra Category 2 in Germany. So let's change back to RFM and define this wind zone 2 with Category 2. Altitude we define here 0 because it's near the water, and consider the mean velocity of this wind speed diagram. In next instance, we can check the load case top, and you will see everything is fine. These four load cases are defined, and these few load cases will be transported to Orwind simulation with following subsettings you can check here in this top: density of air, kinematic viscosity, and so on. Finally, you have also here ruled some parameters about meshing. To get a quick calculation, we change here to mesh size, or let's say mesh density criteria 10%. We want to find a solution with a target residue of 0.001, and we want to mesh the details of the building with the category 2. These two numbers, 10% and level of detail 2, I show you afterwards in Orwind again with a dimension that you have a feeling about which size this means. Finally, on right side, you can define if we or if the wind tunnel calculation should consider turbulence. If yes, here we define standard value of intensity of 1%. This intensity is defined for the inlet of wind tunnel completely all over the surface. So let's take a look on the calculation environment itself. For this, I go back to this load case top and press the easiest solution is to press calculate LC in background or calculate all in background. But if I do this, you don't see something. Therefore, I open one special load case. For example, here this minus x direction, what means wind in 180 degree in our wind simulation. So, and you see it opens a new application called Orwind Simulation. and models here our wedged shape building. And as you can see, the wind direction, the wind will blow against this big back wall, and against this big back wall, and here we have an outlet which is much more longer than the inlet direction. What you can see here also is this wind tunnel deactivated, but we can activate it here, and you will see on the bottom such a grid. Let's check it more in detail. Watch against Z direction, and you see the program is drawing around this region of building a much more finer mesh than around, and this should visualize you that this meshing algorithm behind in this R-Wind program tries to create a mesh, or let's say a solid mesh, in this numerical wind tunnel near building, much more finer than around. And this meshing is defined in the simulation parameters here in this middle section with this mesh density generally. What means if I change this mesh density maybe to 55% and apply, you see the program is changing this distribution. What should you give you an idea how the meshing is done? For our presentation, I move it to 10% to get in a quick timer result. Here in this menu, you can see again this basic information what we transported from RFEM to RWind. Here, inlet velocity, kinematic viscosity, and so on, turbulence data, the wind profile, and so on. In the next instance, you see also here in this navigator on the left side, the model arm which manages models. You see there is a lot of space below. What should give you an idea, you can add more models than one, but at the moment we have one and we can select this. You see this building is highlighted, and if we go into these properties, you get here, you meet this number level of detail what we saw already in our interface in RFM. Here you see size, level of detail 2 means 1.80 meters. If I change it to level of detail 4, means half a meter. It's much more finer. This meshing around building means here this global mesh density of 10% is, let's say, increased near model, and the target size near model is defined with this level of detail. For this analysis we use still here, let's say, level of detail 1 to get a quick result. Okay, finally, before we start calculation, we have here one more option I want to show you. It's the wind tunnel itself. You see the wind tunnel is defined here by two diagonal points in space. X is always this direction in wind direction. If you want to elongate this wind tunnel, you can change it here. For example, if you want to get here 1000 meters, and this wind tunnel is automatically elongated. So far we can think about starting the calculation, and for this I go on right side and pick calculate. Now you see the program is starting with a meshing process. He writes down here the size of mesh. Maybe during he's evaluating this result, I tell something about calculation itself. We use here some special meshing function from OpenFOAM source, which is called a shrink wrap meshing, which we bind around the model. This should help to improve the models when they are not windproof, because if they are not windproof, the wind flow can go inside the building and produce some effects what you don't expect. So we before we start calculation, we bind around all models such a shrink wrap meshing to get a good model for final calculation. The calculation itself is done also with the OpenFOAM solver from open source core, and this core, let's say or describe it, is a much really powerful tool with many options. You can do fluid calculations, you can do heat calculations, you can do everything in once, but our target was to use this core with this special meshing and to program an environment around which is let's say only needed for civil engineers, or we prepared all inputs only what are interesting for civil engineers for getting these wind loads on buildings. All other options we hide with our tool, or we let's say in the first versions we can edit, but now our target was to offer a tool using this high-end calculation core and giving you only these input options which are interesting for civil engineers. After calculation, you see here the program is asking if we should close window and go back to RFM. Let's say no and watch, take a look on results. And you see here directly a big red flag on the building shows us the compression zone. If you move your mouse cursor, you get the value on the point you show, and here we have a pressure, and if we go around side you see we have a suction, the sign is changing, and this is directly calculated for this shape, considered all geometric properties, also this really nice shape form here is considered, and this result surface pressure is let's say only the final result what we get from this CFD calculation, but to get these results we have also to calculate what happens in this space around this building, and here we can take for example a look on pressure field. The pressure field is now a solid result as you can see, but we visualize it like a plane, because if we display it like a solid you get only a rectangle block and you can't see the details near building, and this planes you can move or drag here with this nodes, and you get for every place exact the values where you place these planes. This plane could be also rotated maybe in the cross section. You see here the distribution around in XY plane, and of course you see this is only for a special section of wind tunnel. This is made that you get only these interesting results near building, but of course you can deactivate this reduced domain and get all results for the full wind tunnel. But I think it makes only sense to watch result near the building. Besides this pressure field, you get also a velocity field. Here you see the velocity distribution with the same option to visualize it. And finally, you get to this velocity also a vector. It's visualized here. Maybe I deactivate this wind tunnel as small arrows. And you can see here already this big rotation of wind masses, and these planes could also here changed into maybe this cut region or in this, oh no, here I want here to this cut plane. Yeah, good. And if you know this direction and the color gives us the magnitude of velocity, you can draw also this streamlined graphics, what is quite famous for this type of calculation, and this streamlined graphics could also animate it, what produces us really a good view of this problem, what we calculated to understand these wind loads, and of course it's possible to modify this streamline application. You see here he follow such a random amount of nodes, but of course it's possible to define it and has a segment, for example, and if you say, oh, I'm interested only in a specific region, you go back to this segment settings, add here more points, maybe here you stretch it a little bit, and then you get here some streamlines for this specific section. Yeah, good. If you, this was at least all results what we get here for this type of calculation, but as mentioned on the satellite photo, you see here are some houses around and they could influence the wind load on this big building. And if you want to consider it, the program gives you an option here in data or in model arm. And for this, we add here below model a new model we imported. We use here a STL file, for example. And for this, we go on desktop folder, and here I prepared a STL file with the surrounding buildings. I open it and I say, okay, please move it here. And okay, yes, I want to delete the results. And now we have the surrounding buildings. Unfortunately, not on the right place. We have to rotate it, but this is possible. We can pick it and can define here the right position. I think this should be 108 meters and here minus 85, and we have a rotation of 180 degrees. And if we apply this, it looks much more better. You can see here, if we compared with satellite photos, this is a long building and here the blocks before. And so far we can go ahead with this geometric. But here our wind tunnel border is quite close on this building, so we go to wind tunnel and say, please adjust to model. And okay, now the program increased the wind tunnel size. And we start calculation again, considering these neighbor buildings. It depends on you what you want to consider. You can add so many models you want. You can add also some terrain models, changing the boundary conditions on bottom, that the wind speed running out to zero in this place. Or this is possible. It's maybe regarding calculation, it's a steady state calculation, and you see we have quite good convergence here. Of course, it's a result of this bad, or let's say rough, meshing. And now we have also effect of neighbor buildings. Let's watch here surface pressures, and you see here these buildings on bottom have some influence on this big back wall. And now when this calculation is ready and this results looks promising, we can go back to RFM. For this, I close RWind, open RFM here, and you see the program checked, this option calculated, what means I get results in RFM. And if I close this interface menu, we see here, we have here a lowercase 3 wind 180 degrees. And if I calculate this, the program is applying this wind load as mesh nodes on the building. You see the big back wall is pressed inside the building, and the outer and the other surfaces are pressed outside. This represents now this pressure and suction. And of course, you get here also in surface results are option distribution of loads, which showing to you the wind loads from our wind on different coordinate systems, maybe on global or maybe on local. And here you get a colored map of loads from wind for this wind direction on the building, what is used for calculation for further structural analysis. And this is now also the end of my short presentation. should give you an overview what is possible. You can run, of course, a batch process to calculate all wind directions subsequently, but for giving you an overview what is possible, I used only this wind 180 degrees. So, bye bye.